Liverpool last week in London. Obviously, you were crowned Cup champions, your second Cup title this year. I guess there hasn't been too much time to celebrate with Edinburgh being so close.
Well, I think last week was a good result for us. I mean, especially after beating a quality, you know, Fijian side, I really think they did well. They had a new coach, a few new players. And it's just, I think, credit to them, you know, and testament to also to the quality of players that they have in Fiji, you know, the depth of talent. And for new players to come out, you know, and to play in their first final, I think is also an amazing achievement for them as well. But, yeah, for us it's important to keep the momentum. We would like to finish second on the low. But I know it's important, you know, going into the new season, especially after we're probably going to start the season with three tournaments in a row. So, but like for now, we just want our players to recover, you know, well for this weekend, and hopefully we can have some of the results in Scotland.
You haven't won back-to-back tournaments since 2008. How difficult is it? You see a lot of teams being unable to take out the second week title, having won it the first time.
It's extremely difficult. Yeah, and like you said now, I mean, like the first time that we've won a double tournament was way back in 2008, and that was with a quality team that we've done it. I mean, with Joe Eplon, who became a Springbok, Robert Iverson and Lionel Mapu and Zwandile Stick and Paul Mbeyoza. I mean, those were quality players, and for these guys, are mostly youngsters. Six new players who played their first London Sevens and will be playing here this weekend as well. And it's quite a big ask, you know, for them to go out there and try to give it their best and hopefully to become the second team, you know, to achieve a double. I think New Zealand is the only other team. Fiji might have done it as well in the past, but for us in South Africa, these players have an opportunity where they can really create their own legacy for themselves, and I really think it's something to play for.
You mentioned second place. Obviously, that's now as high as South Africa can finish, but there's four teams with 11 points separating it. Brings another element to this weekend's tournament in Murrayfield.
Well, I think we can finish second or we can finish fifth, so I think it's really up to the players, and it's not going to be any easier. I think Pool D is going to be well contested, and hopefully if we make it to the quarterfinal, it will be either, you know, one of those teams that could stay in our way, you know, to finish second on the log. But we're just going to focus on the things that's important to us as a team, and I think it's all about how you're going to finish the season. You know, it's you're only as good as your last minute when it comes to sevens, and we would like to finish on the high. And I think the players, they've set some good targets for themselves for this week, and hopefully, you know, if they can stick to that and commit to their roles and responsibilities, then our goal is achievable.
And finally, Paul, this season been a successful one and one that you can definitely build on for next year?
Yeah, I think we've achieved every single target and goal that we set for ourselves as a team. When we came to the season, we wanted to give exposure to new players and to young players. We signed five schoolboys. We've given three of them opportunities to play, and William Smith is the last player. But and for those guys to have come out and to have played so well, I mean, we've given them finals and we've given two of them, you know, two tournament wins. And I think that's the most important for us. We want to keep growing as a team. But in terms of how we're finishing, you know, the season and how we've done over the last couple of tournaments, I think that's what the South African public would like to see. You know, the South African supporters are very unforgiving, and if you don't win, you know, then there's no place for you in South Africa, and there's no place to hide. But yeah, I think so. I'm really happy with where we're growing as a team and the development of the individual players. So I think it's something to look forward to this weekend to see if they can step it up once more, and then something to look forward to for next year as well.